So as you can see here, this method actually returns a printable representation of this object, okay? So this get class refers to that specific class, for example, our animal class, okay? So if inside the animal class, this is our animal class, and that get class here refers to that animal class. For example, if I want to actually overwrite this method from another class, so inside the animal class, we are actually overwriting this method, okay? So get class dot get name plus at sign plus integer dot to hex string, okay? So I don't want this code to be executed in my own code, okay? So I just need to delete this return dot to string method here, okay? As you can see here, this super keyword here actually refers to the super class, to the class that we are actually inheriting this method from. So this super refers to this object class, okay? And here, as you can see, it says return super.toString. And it means that return the value of the execution of this line of code here, okay? So when we say return super.toString, it means that it's gonna actually only execute this line of code here, okay? Return getClass.getName plus at sign plus integer.toHexString hash code. So I don't want this code here to be executed, okay? Return getClass.getName plus at sign plus integer.toHexString, okay? So when we say return super.toString, it means that this super refers to the super class, this object class. .toString refers to the implementation of this method, okay? So this is the implementation of this method, okay? This line of code is the implementation of that method. So I don't want to, this code to be executed. So I just need to delete this line of code here. And here I can actually put in my own instructions, my own implementations inside this toString method, okay? So I just want to type in return string dot format. And then inside the parentheses, I need to put in two double quotes, percent s colon percent s space percent s colon percent s space percent d space percent d. Okay. And then I need to put in a comma here. And now I want to actually specify the values that is going to be related to these tokens here, okay? So for the first argument, as you can see, this percent s, I need to put in a value of type string, name, okay, comma. And for the second token, as you can see here, I need to put in another argument of type string, name. I refer to the name of this name instance variable, comma. And my third argument, again, is going to be of type string. So as you can see here, this third token, as you can see, is percent %s. So I need to actually put in an argument of type string, okay? So I just need to put in two double quotes here, color, okay? And then comma, color, okay? So again, I put in a comma here, and here I need to actually put in. So as you can see here, this color here is for this token here, percent %s. Okay, so because I actually put a colon here, I don't need to actually put a colon here and here. And for this token here, percent %d, I need to actually put in an argument of type integer. So amount of speed, comma. And for this token here, I need to put in an argument of type integer, amount of power, okay? And then I need to put in a semicolon at the end of my statement, okay? Okay, whenever I call this method, it's gonna actually give me a human readable string about those variables or objects. Okay, so this is the job of this toString method. And this method is from this object class. And we are inheriting this method from this object class. And that's why we actually put this @ override keyword here. Okay, we are redefining or overriding this method inside our own class. We are actually putting our own implementations inside this method. Okay? So hopefully that makes sense. So let's actually go inside the main activity.java file. And here I want to actually access the animal class and create an object from this animal class and then output those values to the screen. Okay, so now let's actually create an object from this animal class. Okay, so inside the main activity.java and inside the onCreate method here, I need to refer to the name of this animal class, animal. And here, I need to actually give a name to this object, for example, animal1. And then I need to put in an assignment operator here. And then I need to actually put in the new keyword here. And again, I need to actually refer to the name of this animal class, okay? So I need to actually put in a semicolon at the end of my statement. So now, as you can see here, it's now showing us an error. The Android Studio is now complaining. Why? Because inside the animal class, we actually created a constructor that is going to actually accept four arguments, okay? And whenever that we want to actually create an object from this animal class, this constructor is going to be called. So we need to actually put in those arguments here, okay? So the first argument must be of type string, okay? And here I need to specify the name of this animal. So I just need to put in two double quotes here. And the name of this animal is, for example, tiger. And then I need to put in a comma here. The second argument must specify the color of this target, tiger, okay? So I just need to put in two double quotes here. So inside the double quotes, I can just type in orange, for example. And then again, I need to put in a comma here. And my third argument must specify the amount of speed of this object, okay? As you can see here, amount of speed of type int. So I need to put in a value of type int here. For example, number 60, okay? And then I need to put in a comma here. And here, I need to actually put in another argument here of type int. And here, I need to actually specify the amount of power of this object here. As you can see, this argument is of type int. So I need to actually pass in a value of type int, for example, number 80. Okay? So now let's actually create some objects from the TextView class and then refer to these components inside this screen here. Okay? For example, this animal TextView here. So inside the main activity.java here, I need to actually create some text view objects. So I need to actually refer to the name of the text view class. And the name of my object is txt animal. An assignment operator here. An assignment operator here. And then I need to actually put in a pair of round brackets. So inside the round brackets, I need to actually cast this object to a text view object. I'll talk more about casting objects later in this tutorial, but for now just type in text view. Okay everyone, now let's actually create some text view objects. So first of all, we need to refer to the name of the text view class, and then we need to actually give a name to this object, txt animal, and then we put in an assignment operator here, and then we need to cast this object to our text view object. I'll talk more about casting objects in this tutorial. But for now, know that you need to actually cast this object to a text view object, okay? And then we need to type in here find view by id r.id.txt animal, okay? And then I need to put in a semicolon at the end of my statement. And again, I need to refer to the name of the text view class, okay? txt. And my second component is cat, txt cat. And then I put in an assignment operator here, text view, find view by id r.id.txt cat. Okay. Again, I want to create another text view object, txt lion. And then I put in an assignment operator here, and then I cast this object to a text view object, find view by id r.id.txt lion. Okay, text view txt Let's see our, okay, this is our leopard text view here. TXT leopard. And then I put an assignment operator here. And then I cast this object to a text view object. Find view by ID r.id.txt leopard. Okay,